Dudes, what's up?
Me and George.
We're burning the midnight oil here. We're literally, well, I say midnight oil, I'm a dad, man. It's like 9 o'clock, that's the midnight oil for me. I'm actually editing the video that you're about to watch. How cool is that? Oh, let me get this on. I feel naked in front of you guys without my bass. So you know who Verdine White is, right? Obviously, bass player for the legendary Earth, Wind & Fire. Well, a few months ago, I was lucky enough to hang out with Verdine, and I want to share some footage from that day with you today, and specifically about how he got into the bass, how he studied the bass, and the stuff that he practiced to really get where he is today. And really, I was thinking about this over the last week because we've actually just opened my 8-week Practice Accelerator program, and I've just been thinking about nerding out on practice. If you've not checked that out, make sure that you hang around to the end of the video. I'll just give you a quick blurb about what it's about, and if you want to check it out, the link is below this video. But don't go anywhere yet, because you're about to hear Verdine's story about how he got into the bass, what he practiced, the guys that he studied with, him hanging out with Ron Carter recently, and just putting it out there, Verdine is a burning player. Check this out. We are here in the First Direct Arena in Leeds, which is my hometown. Whoop. And we're going to be hanging out with the amazing Verdine White from Earth, Wind & Fire, who is playing on that stage over there.
Oh.
First of all, to the guys watching, thank you so much for coming and hanging out with us today.
Thank you so much.
I have been geeking out on your bass playing forever and a day. I can't tell you how excited I was. Nick behind the camera messaged me the other day and he said, "We're going to get to go and meet Verdine White." I was like, no way. So huge thank you to you. Can I ask you, how did you get into bass in the first place? Because I know that the bass community will be so into, you know, learning more about how you actually came to pick up the bass in the first place.
Well, you know, I started as a you know, a young teenager, you know, and my late brother Maurice, who's responsible for Earth, Wind & Fire and everything, and the fact that this whole Earth, Wind & Fire thing started, he was the one that put this whole thing together. He brought me my first bass, my first upright bass.
Really? So you started 14, out on upright?
Yeah, 13, 14, and I have one at home. I do practice occasionally, but it's in the corner where it's going to stay. It's a furniture piece now. It's a great bass. And then I, you know, started, you know, studying with Roddy Villar from the Chicago Symphony Orchestra.
Gotcha, yeah.
I did that first.
And how old were you at this point?
14, 15, 16.
So it was like all through the school?
All through school.
And like orchestra, the full,
that's
like
right,
learning to read the
Stravinsky
dots.
And Bartok and Beethoven and things like that, West Side Story. But then on weekends, I would study bass guitar with the great Louis Satterfield, who was our trombone player in the Phoenix Horns.
He ended up in the Phoenix
Horns. That's
right.
He was known as one of the Phoenix Horns, but he, in Chicago, he was a big bass guitar session player.
Yeah.
And so every weekend I was at his house. I went to his house every weekend for 5 years.
Wow.
Where I learned about studio work, learned how to read for studio, and learned how to be creative. And so I sort of had the best of both worlds.
Yeah. And when you were doing the classical thing, was there a moment where you decided to go down, like, you know, you thought, I want to do electric bass as well? Or was it always in parallel with each other?
It was parallel.
Always parallel.
It was parallel. Yeah.
And was Maurice an influence there?
Right.
Yeah.
And then ultimately, bass guitar took over because it was changing, prior to that, upright probably was the only one. Although bass guitar came originally in 1951.
Yeah.
You know, which I have a 1951 telly in my trophy room. But
that's all with the slab bodies, isn't it? It's like a chunk of wood.
Yeah, it's just all wood. And but then Satterfield taught me a lot. Everything I knew about bass guitar, I learned from him.
Yeah.
Everything. All
and what kind of what kind of stuff was he taking you through? Was he looking at other people's bass lines? Was he giving you scales to practice?
Well, scales, a lot of blues, just different concept modes, rhythm. He used to take sheets of paper out. We used to read lines. Then I would go from one bar to the next bar to the next bar. But he would put them on the floor.
Yeah.
And so I could just walk them. And then look at the next bar, the next bar, the next bar. So it was really a very learning experience. And then Maurice at the time was Ramsey Lewis's drummer.
Because he was a session drummer originally, yeah.
Then went to the jazz trio with Ramsey Lewis in Chicago. Then he decided to start his own band, you know, Earth, Wind & Fire. Then he asked me to come out.
And that's when he moved down to LA. Before you, didn't he?
Right, he went out about 3 months before.
Enlisted you.
asked me to come out. And that's really where it began for me, you know, really honing my skills and being out there with a lot of the professionals and you know, meeting movie stars that I saw on television. And
how old were you at that point?
18.
Wow. What was it like moving to LA when you were 18?
Going on the other side of the moon.
And who were you listening to, your influences at that point?
It was more jazz guys. It was Ron Carter.
Yeah.
It was Paul Chambers.
Yeah, absolutely, yeah.
Richard Davis, who a lot of people don't know, a great player, Richard. Yeah. Scott LaFaro.
Yeah.
Eddie Gomez.
All the jazz guys.
Yeah. Cleveland Eden.
I haven't heard of that guy.
He was Ramsey's upright bass player. Wonderful player.
Were you ever involved in that? Do you know when you came through, sort of like when you were younger, was there a point where you did think about playing jazz or ended up playing jazz?
No, just
like
music, because coming out of Chicago, you played jazz.
You're just there all
R&B,
the time.
Gospel,
yeah.
Pop. And on the bass guitar side, it was Paul McCartney, because I loved his work. Really loved it.
Yeah.
So melodic on the Hofner. James Jamerson.
Yeah.
And Louis Atterfield. Those were the three bass guitar players, you know. And so it was Ron Carter also too in the upright.
Ronnie,
who's a great friend of mine.
Yeah, you ended up. I watched an interview the other day, and you were like, "Oh, I went to his house, and he was like showing me some stuff."
Yeah, I did. Like, right, I did. Yeah. And I have the books at the house. He said you got to practice an hour a day. I've been getting in like 30 minutes. You know what I mean? But I practice out of Ron's book every day.
When you were younger, were you an avid practicer? Was it something that you were really strict about doing?
Yeah, absolutely.
Yeah,
I used to practice 8 hours a day.
Yeah.
8 hours a day, you know.
Was that before you kind of got to the point where you were making albums?
Yeah, at home, you know, in our late parents' home. Absolutely. It was mandatory, you know. My father was very strict about it. If you're going to play it, you're going to practice. And plus, my brother Fred was a drummer. So, you know, we had a basement downstairs so we could practice and we rehearsed with our little bands.
Whoa, you made it through the full video. Good for you. You're obviously a complete bass nerd like me. Now, obviously, a massive thanks to Verdine for hanging out with us that day. And as I mentioned at the beginning of this video, I've just opened my 8-week Practice Accelerator program for enrollment. We generally only do this once a year, so if you want to get on board, check it out. I'll put the link below. And I really, in this program, have boiled down the perfect practice schedule for you. And throughout the program, we focus on each individual element that you should be practicing every time you pick up the bass. And just to be clear, this program is not going to ask you to practice 8 hours a day or anything like that, okay? This program is about getting super smart about practicing and focusing on the core elements of what's gonna really push your playing forward, okay? If it sounds like it might be for you and you are, you know, wanting to get your bass playing to the next level and you might be, I don't know, stuck with what to do next and what really to focus on to move your playing to the next level, check it out. It's called the Practice Accelerator 8-week program. I'll put the link below and I'd be absolutely over the moon if you checked it out and enrolled. That would really make my day. Anyway, take it easy, guys. I'll see you in the shed.